Good morning everyone, this is IAS Academy welcomes you in the series of MCQs based on daily current affairs for helping you in the upcoming exam of UPSC Prelims 2020. So today we will discuss MCQs of 26 marks, but before, you can download these PPTs from the link given in the description box below, and please take a pause when you see question on the screen, answer it first and then see the explanation part. It will help you in retaining the question and also adjust the speed of the video according to your wish, as the option is given in the YouTube video. So work hard, be consistent, regularly watch our videos and try to get at least 7 questions correct out of 10. So let's begin our today's MCQ. So question number 1 is with reference to recent report of International Energy Agency. First, India is the 5th largest producer of electricity in the world. Second, despite the production, India is a power deficit country. So here, both the same statements are incorrect, so option will be D, none of the above. So according to recently released report of International Energy Agency, India is the 3rd largest producer of electricity in the world, and India has been ranked 106 in terms of per capita consumption of electricity, and India has become a power surplus country, so do remember this fact. And as of December 2019, the national electric grid had an installed capacity of 368 gigawatt, and India's power production is dominated by coal. As of May 2019, 72% of India's electricity was being generated from coal-based power plants. Now, question number 2 is with reference to National Aquifer Mapping and Management Program. So first, the program is an initiative of Ministry of Jal Shakti. Second, it's aimed to assess the availability of groundwater in the country. So here, both the given statements are correct. So option will be C here. So this program is being implemented by Central Groundwater Board, which is under Ministry of Jal Shakti, and it aims to learn about groundwater availability in the country to initiate artificial recharge of underground water, and it aims for mapping of aquifers, their characterization, and development of aquifer management plans to facilitate sustainable management of groundwater resources. And out of nearly 25 lakh kilometers square of mapping area in country, so far the plan have been developed for an area of 11.8 lakh kilometers square covering various part of the country. So do remember, this program is related with Ministry of Jal Shakti and is related with groundwater. Now question number 3 is regarding preamble of the Indian Constitution. So first, preamble is a part of Constitution of India. Second, preamble of the Constitution cannot be amended. So here, statement first is correct, second is incorrect. So option will be A, one only. So according to Keshavananda Bharti case 1973, the Supreme Court pronounced that the preamble is a part of Constitution, and if it is a part of Constitution, the Parliament has full right to amend the preamble. So currently, preamble of Constitution is amendable, and the preamble of Constitution declares India sovereign, secular, socialist and democratic republic, and the context is that a resolution is to be moved in Rajya Sabha to remove the word socialist from the preamble as it was redundant, or you can say of no use in the current situation in India. So what you guys think about it? And the word socialist was added in the preamble of India by 22nd Constitution Amendment Act in 1976, and so far Parliament has amended preamble only once, and that is by 42nd Constitution Amendment Act. Now question number 4 is, Sankalp is an initiative of which of the following ministries? So the correct answer here is Ministry of Skill Development and Entrepreneurship. So option will be B. So Sankalp stands for Skills Acquisition and Knowledge Awareness for Livelihood Promotion, which is an initiative of Ministry of Skill Development and Entrepreneurship, but it is a centrally sponsored project, so do remember it, and it is supported by World Bank, and it focuses on apprenticeship training and support ITI, and the objective are creating convergence among all skill training activities, second, improving the quality of skill development programs to quality trainers, developing moral curriculum and standardizing assessment, certification and evaluation systems, and providing access to industry-led skill training opportunities to the disadvantaged section. Now question number 5 is, India has recently signed a defense deal procuring Negev light machine guns from which of the following countries? So the correct answer is Israel. Option will be B. So the Ministry of Defense has signed a defense agreement with Israel weapons industry to procure Negev light machine guns from the country. And also, you must be knowing that Negev is a desert which is also located in Israel, and the 8800 crore defense deal was signed by Indian Armed Forces for the procurement of around 60,000 light machine guns for the army, and the contracted Negev light machine gun is a combat weapon and currently used by several countries around the globe, and the light machine gun will enhance the lethality and range of a soldier in comparison with presently used weapon, that is IAS LMG. Now question number 6 is, consider the following statements regarding nomination of members in Rajya Sabha. First, nomination of members is implicitly mentioned in the constitution. Second, a nominated member can join a party within 6 months of taking his seat in the house. Third, nominated members enjoy all powers and privileges which elected MPs are entitled to. Fourth, so far no nominated members have been inducted in the Council of Ministers. So here statement first is incorrect, rest are correct. So option will be C. And the statement second is incorrect because Article 80 of Indian Constitution explicitly says that the Council of Ministers, not Minister, states, shall consist of 12 members to be nominated by President. So the provision is explicitly mentioned, not implicit. And the member to be nominated by the President shall consist of persons having special knowledge or practical experience in respect of such matters as following list, that is literature, science, art and social service, and they take part in proceeding of house but are not allowed to vote in the election of President. Do remember, they are not allowed to vote in the election of President, but they have voting right in the election of Vice President. So this might be very confusing. Now question number 7 is, recently Janata Curfew was in news. So first, it applies to everyone. Second, all citizens are suggested to stay inside their home. Third, people in emergency or essential services must not do their regular duty. So here, statement third is incorrect. So option will be C. And it is very obvious, as we are talking about Janata Curfew, which is not authoritative in nature. So statement third is incorrect because those in emergency and essential services should do their regular duties. And recently, PM Modi urges the entire nation to stay at home for the coming few weeks to arrest the spread of coronavirus pandemic. And he said senior citizens aged over 65 years should stay indoors at all costs for the next few weeks. Now question number 8 is, recently Thalweg doctrine was in news. So first, the Thalweg doctrine is key to border demarcation of water courses or flowing bodies of water between nation states. Second, the Thalweg is the line of shallowest elevation within a valley or water courses. So here first is correct, second is incorrect. So option will be A, one only. And the statement second is incorrect because in geography, a Thalweg is a line of lowest, not shallowest elevation within a valley or water courses. Here you can see in the diagram, and it has shown Thalweg, which is the very lowest elevation in the water course. And under international law, Thalweg is the middle of the primary navigable channel of a waterway that defines the boundary line between states, and it is of special significance because disputed river borders are often deemed to run along the river Thalweg, and however it is normally applied on in case of navigable rivers. So do remember, it is applied only on navigable rivers. Now question number 9 is, which of the following is are the quasi judicial body or bodies? So here, National Green Tribunal, National Commission for Scheduled Castes, and Financial Commission, all are quasi-judicial body. So option will be D, all of the above. And a quasi-judicial body is a non-judicial body which can interpret law, and it is an entity such as an arbitrator or tribunal board, generally of a public administrative agency, which has powers and procedures resembling those of a court of law or judge, and which is obliged to objectively define facts and draw conclusions from them so as to provide the basis of an official action. And if you have read the syllabus of UPSC, you must have read about quasi-judicial bodies, which are very important. Now, question number 10 is, Ligingo Island is located in which of the following lakes? So the correct answer is Lake Victoria. So option will be A. So here you can see in the map, this is island. It is located in Lake Victoria. But you can see the Lake Victoria is between Uganda, Kenya and Tanzania, whereas Ligingo Island is a territory which is a disputed territory between Kenya and Uganda. So don't confuse between the two, and the island is extremely densely populated. So here I am wrapping up today's MCQs. Hope you guys are liking the lecture. And in the last, positive quotation is, the harder you work for something, the greater you will feel when you achieve it. So work hard, be consistent. You have time. Please utilize your time properly to multiple revision of these PPTs, because only revision is the key to the success in the examination. Also subscribe our channel and press the bell icon to get the latest updates of the videos. Please like, comment and share the video and spread the knowledge in your surroundings. We will meet tomorrow with the next MCQ. So have a nice day. Thank you.